Hello guys, since I've last spoken to you, I've made some minor adjustments to the Gen 1 display racks. I'll get into those details shortly and give you a full tutorial and parts list for that, all that good stuff. But first, I want to make sure that I'm confident with it working for every car. Now, I've got most of them built, most of the Gen 1 cars, 5 years lineup. From 2015 to 2019. However, the one set that I still want to build before I'm fully confident in these display racks that they work for every car are the F-150 and Ford Model A Hot Rod. So I'm going to get that built and tested, put them up on the racks here, see how they look, and go from there. If you're not familiar with my Gen 2 display racks, let me give you just a quick rundown. I try to keep everything systematic, so I try to standardize these platforms and legs for every car so that doesn't matter what car you choose in the lineup, it will fit onto this standardized system. So that's what I'm aiming for with the Gen 1 cars as well. Just for clarity, the six stud wide speed champions are what I'm referring to as Gen 1. The 8-stud wide or Gen 2. In this video, we're not going to worry about the 8-stud wides because we've already covered that. The F-150 and Model A Roadster are built. It's pretty fun to drive this truck around with this suspension and all, but I think it would give it a better look if it just stayed down like this. Well, we're now going to try to fit this monster-sized truck into this box. Well, of course, we're going to have to add some more height to the legs as we did to fit the Mini. By the way, the legs are using 2x2 corner bricks. All the other cars just need 6-brick height for them to fit, but this one will need more. So the F-150 does fit into the system using 10 bricks, 10 of those corner bricks for the legs. It's a little bit crammed. It works. The wheels stick out a little bit, but not the most showcaseable vehicle on this display, so I probably won't showcase it this way. The Model A fits in there nice and snug with the standard brick height. So let's see how it looks with the rest. It's not bad. So the other oddly sized car is this small Mini Cooper, which is 5 studs wide. Now, you can just set it onto the studs and attach it where the CMF stands sit right here. Just attach it to those studs, and Bob's your uncle. Yeah, so I've added an extra brick height. So there's 7 corner bricks height so I can clear the tires on top of the roof. So it's small in comparison to the other cars, but still works and still looks nice in my opinion. So now that we've got all of the odd-sized vehicles confirmed that they will fit into the system, I feel more confident in proceeding and giving you instructions. Now, last time that I showed you this prototype, I couldn't fit the charger in. And now I can, and how I did that was I extended the length by 2 studs. So 2 extra studs this way. So that's the only difference from the prototype that I showed you in the last video. So in comparing the platform for the Gen 1 cars to the platform for the Gen 2, so it's 2 studs shorter and 2 studs more narrow than the Gen 2 cars. And I tried to use many of the same pieces that I used for the Gen 2 cars. Naturally, there's less pieces involved in building the one for the Gen 1 cars. So how I'm going to break down the parts list in the description of this video is based on platform, pieces used for this platform. Every car needs a platform and 4 legs. So most cars will just use 6 times 4, 24 corner bricks for the legs. And then it's up to you how many caps you want to use. So this is what I'm calling the cap. It's just a tiled off platform, basically, where no car can sit on top of it. Well, at least sit on top without rolling off. So these are the pieces you're going to need to build the platform for your car. It's going to be the same no matter what car you use your platform for. As long as it's the Speed Champions 2015 through 2019. I chose a random car to demonstrate. Well, actually, I chose this car because it's your favorite, fan favorite of the original 2015 lineup. So I'm going to take one of these 2x12 plates, attach the 2x2 plate here on the end. I'm going to do that four times. I'm going to take a CMF minifigure stand to connect two of them like that. I'll do the same with this. Now, these you don't have to buy if you've got, you know, extra CMF stands. I'm going to take a 2x16 plate and attach it to the CMF stands. Right like that. Okay, a 2x6 tile. Just like that. All right, now the rest of the pieces are going to be placed depending on where the wheels rest with the car. So you want to get it centered on your platform. That looks pretty good. So we're going to put these 1x2x2/3 bricks with bows where the wheels are going to sit. So that's where it's going to go. Let's go ahead and put those in place so don't lose its spot. All right, so just to make sure, yeah, those are where the wheels are going to rest. All right, now I'll put the wheel rests on the other side in the same position. Now I'm gonna have to take them back off to get the tiles underneath. So one thing I would suggest is always place a tile to cover this crease, you know, the gap between the two plates. For example, a 1x4 tile would be great for stability. So we're just gonna use all of these tiles, get it all tiled up and look pretty. So we want to evenly distribute the pieces on each side. So have it mirrored, or else you're not going to have enough pieces. So I've got my 1x3 tiles there. I'll place this 1x4 over here. Do the same thing on the other side. Now I'm left with 1x2s, And they'll fit in nicely right here. Perfect. There, it looks nice, doesn't it? But let's say I didn't want to display my LaFerrari. Actually, I've got an F1 car. So the wheel span is different, but it doesn't matter. We're going to make it work. So let's get this disassembled. Take this car off. All right, as you can see, the wheels are not resting in these spots. So we'll do some minor adjustments. Yeah, we can just move these back one stud. Let's just take a look at that and see if it's centered how we'd like it. I think that looks pretty good. We even could have gone back, shifted these back one more stud. I think that would look better. Let's do it. Yeah, I think that looks better. Now let's finish the tiling work. So, yeah, that's one way to do it. Don't forget the cap. Yeah, looks good. Now, the cap is new to my design. It's easy to build, just plates and tiles. But it really does cap things off nicely. So, the plates that I use are the same exact plates for the platforms. So 4 2x12 plates and 1 2x16 plate. And then the tiling, you can see it's got 1 2 3 4 2x6 tiles. Oh, no, actually 6 2x6 tiles. 4 2x4 tiles on the corners. 4 1x2 tiles. And then I think I'm going to do something differently with these 2x4 tiles and these 2x2 tiles. I'd like to make it symmetrical. So instead, just using a 2x3 tile on each side of this 2x6. And that way, this 2x6 tile can be spread equally over this gap in plates. I think that will provide a little bit more structure as well. I don't have enough 2x3 black tiles in my inventory, so just for demonstration, I'm going to use a different color. But if you order pieces for these, you're definitely going to want to go with black. I haven't tried all the other colors. I mean, you're welcome to try it. I'd be interested to see what it looked like as white or something off the wall. Yep. Just grabbing what I have here. Yeah. I think I like the look of that, besides the color, just the symmetry and yeah, it looks good. So I think that covers all of the details on how to build these racks. Right now I've only got 7 displayed because I need more parts. So I'll go to lego.com and pick up these parts so I can display all of my cars here. Or you can go to bricklink.com and buy some used parts to save some money.